Hello there, God's own special people, God's own very best people who are co-heirs with Jesus to the throne of the Father. You are all very welcome to this edition of Meaningful 5 Minutes with Mommy Reads. We heartily appreciate you all for your views, your likes, your comments, your shares, your subscriptions, and all that you are doing to get the good news across to all nations. We pray that as you continue to spread the good news, may good news never depart from your home in Jesus' name. Yes, together we have ascertained the fact that salvation was made possible because Jesus died on the cross of Calvary for you and for me. And so if you have not yet gotten it right with Jesus, my brother, my sister, remember that the clock is ticking. Hallelujah. We've also been able to deliberate on several topics from slots 1 to 93. The last being the fact that we need to get our walk with God right before we can begin to walk for God. As one subscriber said, we should not serve as signposts who will be pointing in the direction of heaven when we ourselves are not on the way to heaven. Hallelujah. On that note, today in slot 94, we'll be talking on a topic that concerns you and that concerns me. Our topic in slot 94 is Don't Look Back. Hallelujah. And we have as main passage Romans chapter 8 verse 1, where we are told that there's therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus and those who are called by his Spirit. Hallelujah. Beloved in the Lord, sometimes we try to walk right with God. Sometimes we are trying to do our best to get it right with God. But the enemy, being the accuser of the brethren, as we are told in Revelation chapter 12 verse 10, comes to accuse us, comes to remind us of the sins that we have committed in the past. But we should remember that the Bible tells us in 1 John 1:9 that if we confess our sins, God is faithful and just to forgive us and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So I don't know that sin that is eating you up, that sin that you think that is too big for God to forgive. Is it rape? Is it abortion? Is it sexual immorality in all its forms? Is it drug abuse? Is it alcoholism? Whatever sin that it is, as long as you have confessed the sin, my brother, my sister, know that God has forgiven you. If you are able to make amends and you have already made amends and you have repented, that is, you have made a U-turn and turned your back on the sin of the past, let no devil deceive you. You have been forgiven by God Almighty. Because we are told in Isaiah 1:18 that though our sins be as scarlet, God will make them white as snow. God is not interested in the gravity of the sin, but in the sincerity of the repentance. So whatever sin it is that keeps coming to mind, that keeps plaguing you, that keeps haunting you, that keeps infringing your walk with God, that serves as a stumbling block each time you want to make a move with God, you keep reminding yourself, or the enemy keeps reminding you of this sin or that sin that you have committed, bear in mind that no sin is too big for God to forgive and no sin is too small for God to punish. So if you have genuinely repented, if you have genuinely confessed, God has forgiven you. Hallelujah. Sometimes we are tempted to feel bad because maybe the sin that we were living in was very profitable to us. Whether it was whatever the sin was, whether it is prostitution or drug trafficking or whatever sin that was giving you gain. My brother, my sister, it is not time to regret because you stand to gain a lot as you have given your life to Jesus. We should remember that we are told in Proverbs chapter 10 verse 2 that ill-gotten wealth does not prosper. If we continue to thrive in ill-gotten wealth, we should know that our end is in hell. Because we are told that what shall it profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his soul in hell. So if you have made an effort and you are walking right with God, you have gotten it right with Jesus as your Savior, beloved in the Lord, don't look back on the gain that you were making while you were still a sinner. Hallelujah. Another thing that we can be tempted to do is to feel that maybe it is not worth it because the accuser of the brethren keeps accusing us, keeps making us to feel that all hope is lost, that there's no way that we are getting into heaven. But when the enemy comes to remind you of your past, remind him of his future, which is condemnation in hellfire. Remind him of your own future, which is glorious in heaven. When you begin to drown yourself in the word of God and meditate on what God has said, because we are told in Joshua 1:8 that this book of the law shall not depart from our mouth, you begin to tell the enemy that greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world, that he that the Son has set free is free indeed. And that, of course, if anyone is in Christ, he's a new creation. And as our main passage of today has said, that there is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Beloved in the Lord, rest assured, the enemy will flee because the word of God is what you need to remind yourself of your position as a child of God. As you continue to walk with God, don't let anyone, don't let any enemy remind you of the sins that you have you have confessed and make you feel that you are not forgiven. If you are out there, you have not yet given your life to Christ, just say, Lord Jesus, wash me with the blood of the Lamb. Take me back as your child. Make me whole and give me the power to live right for you. Beloved in the Lord, God has forgiven any sin that you have confessed and that you have repented from. Our main passage is Romans 8, verse 1. Remind yourself that you are not condemned because Jesus Christ has set you free. If you are blessed, you can share to bless others. The Bible remains the road, Jesus the code, sin the obstacle, and heaven the destination. Shalom, good people.